Hey there, so I wanted to test out if I could actually edit videos on the Gateway laptop that I've been using for all this time. I've pretty much just been using it to test games, but I've never tried it for video editing itself. So I decided to just give it a go on Premiere and actually try to record a normal video that I do just with another laptop to see if it can be done on here. Now, to do this, I decided I'm going to use this Anchor USB-C dongle here so that I can get Ethernet and a few more USB ports so that we can have the full setup going here. And here you'll be able to see what the actual setup is like. My laptop there on the side hooked up to my LG 1440p monitor. You can see my audio interface and my speakers. This is what I normally just use all the time. And of course, we're going to need to capture the gameplay with this AVerMedia Live Gamer Ultra. Now, jumping into OBS, I got to show you the settings that I use to record here. And I recorded in 1440p because 4K was really pushing it, but 1440p, it did a fantastic job. You can see that I have the quick sync settings here, and you can see what I have them at. These were the best settings that I found for this. It really gave the best possible performance. Now, I use Adobe Premiere for editing, and I find that the performance on here was actually pretty great. Playing back the 1440p gameplay was perfectly fine. It was super smooth, no problems whatsoever. And the types of videos that I make really aren't that complicated. There's not a lot of edits that need to be done, not a lot of effects being done at all. It's usually just the gameplay itself needs to be cut around. Audio needs to just be rebalanced. There might be some overlaying video here and there. And in terms of voiceover, the voiceover is usually just edited through on Adobe Audition just to, you know, get the volume level matched up and to remove any potential clicks or pops that might happen while speaking. So it's not a hard process whatsoever. And this is usually the editing process that I find for things like Let's Plays and stuff like that. So if you want to do gaming videos, it really honestly, it does not take a lot to edit them depending on the style of video that you're trying to make. Even when you're just adding in a lot of text, you know, doing some like, let's say, I don't know, like Swagger Souls type videos where there's a lot of, you know, text on the screen and all that. Doing that and doing the, you know, tracking for all that, it's time consuming, but not necessarily resource heavy. So it really just depends on the style of video that you're making. For gameplay videos like this, where I'm just, you know, testing out hardware and just showing you the raw gameplay, you can make your decisions from there on how the performance is like. It's easy to do. It doesn't require a lot. And honestly, the computer is powerful enough to do that really, really well. And it could do 4K editing, just not, you know, like recording 4K, because recording 4K really requires a lot more resources than what this is capable of. Now, in terms of exporting, I use this plugin called Vocoder that like lets you gain more, I guess, control over what you can do export wise. You can see here, here's the panel for it, and these are the export settings that I have for using QuickSync. Now, Adobe does have support for hardware acceleration from a variety of different, you know, chips. You know, they support Intel, AMD, and NVIDIA chips, but they don't give you that much control. And I find that this program, Vocoder, it lets you really fine tune what you want to do with the exports. And I actually find that it exports quicker because of the fact that it has better resource management. You'll see that your PC is actually doing more work, and it's actually tangible more work, where it will export things quicker. Well, if you just use the default like encoding settings or hardware encoding settings in Premiere, it just is a lot slower. It's less resource intensive, but it ends up just being slower, and I would prefer things to just finish quicker. So we're going to just start the render here, and you'll see that it actually rendered pretty quickly. It was about a 7.5 minute video, and it took about 9 minutes to export out. So exporting is not the issue here. It's the experience while editing that matters the most, really, because exports, they could take an hour. They could take 3 hours. It doesn't really matter at the end of the day if you're not just churning out content 24/7. Now, all of this is really just dependent on the style of videos that you want to make, because here I have some footage that I recorded that needed to be stabilized. And as you can see, it's going to take quite a long time to actually stabilize, because it has to go frame by frame, just, you know, stabilizing it. And it's saying it's going to estimate around 15 to 16 minutes. And that is a very long time for a clip that is not even a minute long. This is a very, very long time in terms of just having to have this effect process through. So if you're going to be doing effects heavy edits and stuff like that, you're going to be taking a very, very long time to do it. And I would say it's really just not doable. So really, it all just depends on the type of content that you're trying to make. You know, effects heavy stuff that you're trying to do, it's just not going to be that doable on here. But if you're doing simple stuff, you know, you're getting started, I think this is a good starter. It's a great laptop to just start, you know, easy video editing. You're not trying to do complicated stuff. You're just trying to record gameplay of your, you know, console and just edit together a nice little video just for YouTube and stuff like that. You know, simple things it can do without a problem, but effects heavy stuff, it gets kind of crazy. And if I try to stabilize multiple videos, it just gets to the point where resources are just getting eaten up like crazy. But video editing is just one part of the YouTube equation. The other part is, of course, you know, creating thumbnails. And I made this thumbnail for the Halo video that I uploaded onto this laptop using GIMP. And GIMP is what I use for all of my thumbnails just because I'm really familiar with it. It's free, open source, fantastic. So I would say that this is just a win. You can just do practically everything that you need on here. You know, you need the audio editing, you can do that. You need the video editing, you can do that. You need the thumbnail creation, you can do that. Overall, I'd say that this is a pretty big win for what is essentially just really cheap hardware.